The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet mesquite. Repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Eric'sFamilyBBQ.com.
When was the last time you had really good Texas-style barbecue? Eric's Family Barbecue, the way it's supposed to taste. Always delicious, never rushed, and prepared to perfection. Eric's Family Barbecue uses only 100% fresh meat, slowly smoked over mesquite wood until it's juicy and delicious. We all know their brisket is the best, but have you tried their pulled pork, pork ribs, or rib tips? Amazing, and their sides are all house-made. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Make the trip. You won't be sorry. Go to Eric'sFamilyBBQ.com for more information.
A little bit of everything. I do some singing, some dancing, some chatting with the guests, the skits, the monologues, the comedy.
Wonderful comedy.
It really is a lot of fun.
I love it. Might be my favorite thing you've done all year.
There's coffee in it.
There you go. Thanks, Pearl Jam. I'm getting emails from people saying, John, you're not giving your opinion on Julius Jones in Oklahoma. And I'm like, Julius Jones, the running back for the Cowboys?
Or the wide receiver?
No, that's Julio Jones.
Oh,
which
that's
also
right. Yeah.
Was
okay.
My second thought. I'm like, is somebody spelling this wrong?
Yeah.
But it is. And I do know this, but I just haven't paid a lot of attention to it. Is they're about to execute an innocent guy in Oklahoma. And I'm like, they've been doing that for years. But there's protests and stuff. And evidently there's been a clemency board and all that stuff that says the 3-1, let him go. And the governor's going to call today. So the countdown's on until 4. But I haven't given my opinion on it. I do know a little about it. And here's where sports in my life and passion overtake humanity and empathy, which, Marcus, I'll have you look those words up later. It's an amazing thing you should look into. But those two things escape him. Yesterday, when talking about the Julius Jones situation, I was watching the news, and they're going through both sides. The dude's been in jail and said that he's actually ratted a dude out and said that my roommate is the one who framed me for this. And he went to jail for 15 years, and he's out. And he's like, this is the dude that did it. And, like, everybody's kind of like, maybe so. So he's out of appeals and all this other stuff, so he's going to go to the electric chair at 4. And people are like, no, he's innocent. Like, this is kind of proof that he's innocent. Like, something's going on here. In the same token, not the greatest individual in the world, not a stand-up citizen. But then Baker Mayfield, quarterback of the Browns, came up and started tearfully talking about how it would hurt him if this happened. So I kind of am rooting for this guy to get executed.
Oh, jeez.
That's where sports and Cleveland Browns coming to the defense of anyone. I'm like, oh, that hurts Baker Mayfield? Cook him. That dude like it, too. Cook him before the disconnect the governor's phone and cook him.
Give me the hood. I'll flip the switch. No problem. Switch.
I know that is not a nice thing to say. But when I see Baker Mayfield cry like an angel gets its wings or something, I'm happier than I've ever been in my life. I feel like I add a year to each dog I own if Baker Mayfield's crying and saying, well, you know, if Baker Mayfield or any...
You enjoy his commercials.
Oh, no. I hate him. I wish the house that Baker built would fall on him. And what's going to be great is when the Browns don't pay him and he has to go somewhere else and he's no longer a superstar, which is coming. We're only 3 months away from that. So, every time a Cleveland Brown says, you know what would hurt me? I immediately start thinking about how to buy the thing he's about to say. You know what would hurt me a lot? What? If they cooked this dude in Oklahoma. I'm like, rally the troops. Let's call the cavalry. Let's get down there and cook this guy. So I know that's not human kindness. But when a Cleveland Brown speaks, whatever he says, I want to be the opposite. And if Cleveland Brown is going to actually go on TV and say the words, this hurts my feelings, I am now for whatever that is. As long as it's not hurting animals. anything he says, if Baker Mayfield came out and said, look, being an atheist is amazing, and I would consider a religion. I would like maybe switch out. I'd go with
call Father Dale up,
have him flip a coin. Maybe. Oh, yeah, I blow Father Dale. I can't smell anything right now, so I might as well take a
you
shot.
You put your swim trunks back on.
Yeah, I'd trunk up and head to the hot tub with old Dale Fushak. Child molester. Anywho. Well, allegedly. But so the Julius Jones thing to the people that are asking. Yeah, I've followed a little bit. My theory in life is if you're on death row, you were probably in a bad situation to begin with. I know you may not have done what you're being accused of, but if you're adjacent to someone who's on death row and you're part of the story, you probably need some jail time for something, I think. Like if Brett goes to death row tomorrow for a thing and they're like, John, you were in on it. I'm like, I was way too close to a dude who murders. I should probably sit out a few plays. And then if Baker Mayfield says we shouldn't execute this guy, I mean, I'm ready to just roll on one. You didn't wet the sponge, Percy.
Yeah, well,
the Browns guy said it would hurt him more. So anything that
he was a killer on the football field.
Yeah, anything that makes Baker Mayfield, it's not the same guy, Brady. It is not the running back for the Cowboys.
Oh
no, this guy's been in jail for 20 years. You want to do his eulogy real quick?
Maybe.
Loves whacking his putt and murder.
Anywho. So that's my take on it. You guys wanted a more serious thing. You know, anybody who was asking, I'm like, I don't know why you're asking me. You see Baker Mayfield talking about this? Anytime a Cleveland Brown speaks, fry the person they're talking about. I'm fine with it.
It would just crush me deep down in my soul if this execution takes place.
Who else does that apply to? Because we could get 4 or 5 of these out of the way and really break this guy down. So that's my take on the Julius Jones thing. I don't know enough about the story. I just have a feeling that if you're on death row, you're probably a bad person. Maybe innocent of the crime you've committed. You were way too close to it to be convicted of something for the to be executed, I think. I can live my life pretty secure in knowing.
But still,
that I'm not going to be confused,
John,
for a friend who
murdered.
Oh, I understand that. But if I, again, you know, I'm Brady, I'm never going to be in a situation where I'm confused for a guy who I knew to be put to death in jail. Like,
and
I'll never be in that spot.
And some of these situations have been that
never.
Exact.
That is never the case. That is
sure has.
Nope. Never once has it been the case.
These guys are getting
like,
overturned.
Huh? There's tons of overturning that they didn't do the crime.
Oh, we arrested
but
the wrong
not
guy.
Hearing. You're not hearing.
Okay. Yeah.
I will never, ever promise you this. FanDuel bet wouldn't even take the bet. I will never be in a situation where the police are like, you were there? Yeah. You knew the guy? Yeah. He killed everybody? Yeah. Did you do it? No. You're going to jail because we got enough evidence that you're close. You're too close.
I understand
close to
that.
Never happened.
Yeah.
So you have to be kind of adjacent to a murder or a murderer enough to make people go, he did it. I'll never be in that situation. I will never be just arrested and like confused for someone. Because I know for a fact, if you like, you're murdering people, I'm probably going to turn you in. I know Brett hates hearing that, but I'm going to turn you in.
Unbelievable.
I'm going to rat your ass out. Because the reason why?
Rats get bats.
Because you know why? Rats also go to jail. Non-rats go to jail
knowing.
For knowing that Brady killed like 9 people. I'm like, I knew about that. And now they're saying, I did it? I'm telling. So when it comes to murder,
do your time.
Nope. No, you don't do your time. That's life. And I'm going to sit in the electric chair.
Shut your mouth.
No.
Do your time.
You're a moron. Part of your time is that little silver hat. That is not doing my time. If I get confused and get sent to death row and I didn't do anything, it doesn't happen that way. You're too close to it to even be confused or mixed up in it. So my guess is Julius, probably not the greatest citizen. Did he murder these people? Does he deserve death row? He might be innocent of the crime he's been accused of. Sure. Does Baker Mayfield want him to live?
Yeah.
That changes my mind. If Baker Mayfield said, try him, I'd be like, this guy's innocent. But there's no situation where a guy's just walking down the street and he's like, I've done absolutely nothing. I don't know who you're talking about. I was nowhere near the scene of the crime. I had nothing to do with this. And they just throw him in jail and put him on death row. Doesn't happen. You have to be real close to it to get a death conviction.
Well, you hear about some of these stories that it has happened that way.
You hear about stories where people have been executed for something they didn't do. But the reason they're in jail and about to be executed is because they were real close to the thing they're being accused of. Whether they did it or not is not, is the innocence thing. You're way too close to murders and your story sucks for you to go to death row. Now, years ago, it was a lot of racism and things like that.
Yeah.
There's truth to that. But I'm talking about now? No. I don't buy it.
That's what I was talking about.
I don't buy
the racism back in the day.
I simply don't buy it. You're way, like, Brett knows about murder. He's Italian. You're way too close to the situation if you're being accused and convicted and put to death. You were almost there. You probably had something to do with it. Now, did you pull the trigger? That's up for debate. And if Baker Mayfield says he likes you, Johnny's cooking you. That's how I feel. That's your entertainment show.
That sounds like a good legal system there.
It is a good legal system.
I don't like this guy's opinion.
I didn't say
that. Look, that, I'm not in charge of it. I'm just saying my thoughts are, if Baker Mayfield's on it, I'm going the other way. That's it. If a Cleveland Brown says they shouldn't fry him, I say they should. It's a 50-50 with or without Baker Mayfield. I think you've done some stuff in your life. It's, you know, your friends, you know, you're only as good as the friends you have around you. And if they're murdering people and you're accused of it, you probably were doing some bad stuff, too.
Allegedly.
Right. Italians always that. The Entertainment Drill is brought to you by ReactDefense.com. Defend yourself from people like Baker Mayfield's friends. Murderers. Anybody who likes Baker is probably a murderer. And you can check it out, TacticalBlack.com. They got the gift cards. I got a guy who said my kid was a All-State NCAA super wrestler, all this stuff in high school and college, and he's like, he doesn't have any street skills. Can they help him? I'm like, can they help him? He's got a little bit of a leg up with his wrestling skills, but they're going to teach him how to turn wrestling stuff into street fighting. Totally different animal. Street fights, they don't have rules. You don't have that, you know, the referee that's going to come in, can't do that. And street fighters know that. The street doesn't care. So if you've got a little extra skill going in, you're athletic, it's just going to help you advance a little quicker. But everybody, you don't even need any skills. They'll teach you from beginning. So the little wrestling thing you got, that's going to help you with a couple of understanding moves. But then when you start getting into how to use it for, you know, ending a fight, ooh, it's a different beast. And it is a blast to learn. So, yeah, gift cards are available for the holidays. The certificates are right there. Buy one right now. Get a month for free. ReactDefense.com. You got anything good, Brady, before we go?
No.
You don't have anything in there at all? We're in a hurry now.
Ivan Moody from Five Finger Death Punch has a book out. Dirty Poetry.
Oh. All right. You don't have anything good.
It's got illustrations.
All right, so on that note. Never mind. I thought you said, yeah. Is it Ivan Moody's Dirty Poetry?
Yeah. And he's got
chalk
an artist.
Outline on the porn room floor.
I don't know. Jim Morrison did the poetry thing, and it was terrible, so
yeah,
I don't know.
I hate Jim Morrison. If Jim Morrison said, don't execute someone, I'd want that guy get executed as well.
What about the guys from 311?
Oh, man. I want to execute them for even...
You got to go to the execution. My friend likes executing all the people.
Anything they say, I do the opposite. If they said coconut's bad, I'd eat bunches of it. Put a lime in that. Anyway, let's be done, shall we? Thursday's in the books. Thanks to BlackRock Coffee for having Brett out there all morning long.
And Sanderson Ford.
Ford giving away cars.
Yes.
Amazing. And that's going to continue on. 10 cans of food, and BlackRock will help you out there. And Sanderson Ford's got you in the drawing for a new Ford or a new Lincoln. For Operation Santa Claus, an amazing charitable event that happens each and every year. Thanks to Sanderson Ford for letting us be part of that and helping you guys advance that cause just a little bit that we can. That's great. You guys have a great Thursday. We will see you tomorrow right here in the Morning Sickness. So long.
Hey, here we go.
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet Mesquite. Repeat. Eric's Family BBQ.com.